it's better if I just start and just keep going. Okay, well, as far as our launch and wonderful catch of the Starship in Boca Chica, Texas, well, that was pretty amazing. A 10-story building floating in the air? Yeah, it was pretty cool. I will warn people that if you look at secondary photos, I wish people wouldn't do this, but some people are trying to make them look better, and that's not a good idea, because we need to know what is actually wrong. That's how the whole system works. The Musk idea is you do it, and then you see what is good and what is bad, and if you can't see what's bad, and the more people who see what's bad, the better it is. So that's just my idea. And I wish people would stop just talking about the booster, which was amazing. Yeah, that was the first part. There's three parts. And the first part is the really big, tall, white, stainless steel thing. And that came back to Earth and was caught. Unlike, I think, a Chinese ship that was trying to be reusable, had the legs collapse under it just a few days later. And it wasn't pretty. So the catch idea, well, I think it evolved. Do I think we had a role in it? I'm on a chat room occasionally called Jamie Builds. That's Jamie with J-A-I-M-I-E. And I asked him, he was a very, very, very creative person in industrial type of ways. Very industrial artist, and they're very rare to find. And he said it could be done, but you got to be careful not to crush it. Well, it had been just a couple of pipes. Now, they might have been planning to do this, so I can't 100% say it, but they put what I jokingly kind of called the baby booster bumpers on, and it appears to have worked. It was hanging there for hours. But Starship landing, if you were there to see it, if you had to, your time was definitely not well timed. Sunday morning at, I think about 6, was when the Starship finally, and that would be the third part. You had a second one in there that kind of goes somewhere, but it's a smaller unit. They don't need much propulsion when they get up high. Big ones for down low, middle ones for upper atmosphere, and then you use your propulsion on the actual Starship when you're in orbit, or close to orbit, I think. When Starship came down, which was a little soon after, and it was supposed to splash down into the Indian Ocean. And that's the Indian Ocean, okay? Not anywhere around here. And we see the cameras, and it's going down, and it looks like it's just perfectly going to plop into the ocean. And it didn't break up or anything like that. It didn't look bad. Then we find out, something happened. There was a little fire, but it looked like a sterno fire. Like, kind of thing at a tiki bar where they have oil on the water and it starts burning. You know, very, very thin flame. No explosion that I recall. But we forget that in other parts of the world, they don't use dispersant on oil when it goes into the water. America might look really clean, but don't look down below, because it just drops to the bottom, and that can cause more environmental damage than having it on the surface. However, if you land a rocket on the surface of an oily ocean, it burns, and that's what it looked like. So, to my understanding, if it didn't eventually blow the Starship up, which it might have, if they say that it blew up, that is my hypothesis, it could still be floating out there. A nice week. Bye-bye.